An Amarillo man is in the hospital tonight, thankful to be alive after what he says was a near-death experience caused by vaping. ABC 7's Lamaya Harvell spoke with him today. She joins us live in studio now with his story and a counterpoint from a local vape shop owner. Lamaya?
The epidemic of vape-related illnesses has increased over 500 cases nationwide. 11 people have died, and this has all led the White House to begin developing a policy that would ban flavored vaping products entirely. But not everyone agrees.
I was dancing on Sunday with my granddaughter, and Tuesday I felt like I was on my deathbed.
Benjamin Camarillo says he went to the hospital because he thought he had pneumonia.
It felt like I couldn't breathe on my own. Felt like I had somebody sitting on my chest, maybe.
When he arrived, Camarillo collapsed. Doctors ran a CAT scan that revealed his lungs were clogged.
And I immediately knew what it was from. I knew it was from vaping.
Camarillo says he has PTSD and would use both THC and flavored vaping products to help him through the day.
Every time new products would come out, I would take a trip and go grab them and try to use them as discreetly as possible.
Cases like these have led the government to consider banning all flavored vaping products. Owner of 806 Vapes, Chris Goodwin, says they're blaming the wrong culprit.
There's several products to vape. E-cigarettes are one way to vape. That's nicotine containing products, like
which are sold at 806 Vapes and many other shops around the nation.
You can also attempt to vape cannabis oil out of a THC cartridge.
Goodwin says the cannabis vapes include vitamin E acetate, used to thin out the oil enough to vape. He says this is what's causing the rare illness, not flavored nicotine.
Vitamin E acetate's a lipid, it's a fat. When you vaporize vitamin E acetate, it's gonna stick. And that's a bad thing.
Pulmonologist and intensivist Mark Singler says the city has had several cases that may be associated with nicotine vaping, but none has been confirmed.
We do not have a diagnostic test to say this is from vaping.
Singler says it's hard to regulate what can and can't be vaped because officials aren't sure of what chemicals are in them.
Sometimes they're related to THC, which is probably the most likely compound they're related to, similar to marijuana. CBD oils are another suspect in what is causing these illnesses.
And it shouldn't be limited only to just flavored vaping products. Singler says because the epidemic is changing every day, officials are still trying to find a set treatment that will work the best.
Now I asked Dr. Singler if he believes we should just ban all aspects of vaping, and he says at this point, the risks outweigh the benefits, and if you are vaping, you need to stop. I'm in the Kennedy Broadcast Center, Lamaya Harvell, ABC 7 News.
Thank you, Lamaya. And along those lines, the Oklahoma State Department of Health has confirmed its first case of a vaping-related illness. The department only said the patient is under the age of 18 and lives in the Tulsa area. The Oklahoma Health Commissioner says they are working with state and federal partners to learn what they can about this case in order to prevent further injury or death. The department advises against buying e-cigarette and vaping products off the street or adding substances not intended by the manufacturer.